In one of our previous videos, we went through the process of downloading Microsoft Power BI desktop version. However, we never got the chance to delve into the environment and explore the various tabs and views and the numerous visualization options that allow us to better interpret our data. And that was because that SKU was focused on introducing the tool and understanding that there are other options available out there that allow us to integrate our on-prem data using Microsoft Power BI on-prem data gateways to beam that data to Microsoft Power BI. So right now we'll focus on the Microsoft Power BI desktop and its cloud-based counterpart, the Microsoft Power BI service, to better understand how these tools work and how we can better interpret our data and have greater visuals that rightly interpret the kind of changes that are occurring with your environment. With that said, I invite you to come along. So Power BI Desktop is more like the engine. This is where much of the work is done in terms of modeling or data ingestion or anything that actually needs to be interpreted into visuals. It has to pass through this particular area. Now, as you may see over here, this is something that you'd have installed on your device as we saw in the previous nuggets, and it's something that you actually can use offline. So here I have my Power BI Desktop. I can begin bringing in data from various sources or even go straight away and begin exploring the various tools in here. Now, if you are a data analyst, or maybe you're a data engineer, or you are a business intelligence manager, you're going to spend much of your time in this particular environment. Now, there are three main categories that you have to pay attention to. So when it comes to visualizing our data within Microsoft Power BI Desktop, these are our three different types of views. We might actually be visualizing our data within the report view, which is where we are currently. And the report view would come with its own tabs and different tools that allow us to execute different types of features. And this is great for creating different types of reports, or maybe we simply want to have various visual elements such as making use of charts and different maps, etc. The report view is the go-to type of view for those kind of things. However, there are times we may simply want to make use of the actual raw data that has been fed into Power BI. The table view would be the go-to view for those kind of tasks. Using the table view, we'd be able to look at the data as it is, would actually be able to have various columns and rows, and we'll be able to work with the data directly. Now, what this offers us is the ability for us to edit that data, making changes to it, making maybe some filtrations where we simply get rid of certain types of data, or maybe add certain columns and be able to perform different calculated features, etc. This is something that might be required at the process of maybe remodeling your data, or maybe you're simply trying to combine different sets of data. That can only be achieved within this particular area or the table view. And finally, you also have what is known as the model view. The fundamental concept behind the model view is relationships. Now imagine yourself looking at sales data, and that sales data could actually be giving you information regarding different products. Maybe you've got various products within your environment, and you can also look at maybe sales per region. And apart from that, you could also maybe have an understanding as to maybe the different seasons or times of the year at which these sales were happening. And you're able to visualize that information based on these metrics. And this simply allows you to have an understanding of what could be happening within your environment. Perhaps the sales at a particular season of the year, let's say this was January, was low compared to sales that were maybe happening in August, for example. And you'd be able to understand that those sales were lower because maybe a particular region would be experiencing their winter, or maybe it is summer in that part of the world, and maybe various other aspects to do with those kind of projects. And from the model view, you'd be able to understand these relationships and how they'd be driving the various changes in terms of profits or losses within your organization. And in addition to that, you'd then be able to define the relationship between the various products that you have and the different regions in which you're selling them, and whether there is a direct impact based on the season in which those products are sold, and if there is anything that needs to be changed in order for you to be able to maximize your performance or your return on investment in that particular business. So these are the three major views that we'll be dealing with as we progress in this particular skill. Now you'd notice that each one of them comes with different additional tabs or other tabs that are simply shown when you click on it. That's very important for us. And as you may have noticed from our home tab, we have different data sources in here. So from this location, we can select a different data source and be able to bring in our data into our report and begin working with that data as we may desire. We can also do the same thing from this location over here. This could actually include data from our Excel workbooks, from our SQL servers, or other data sets that we may have in different locations. And once data is in here, we can also go ahead and even maybe think of creating a new page from where we can create a different report. And once we've got the report displayed in this location, it is now up to us to begin using the different visualization options which you're seeing on our far right hand side in this area. And we have different options in here. However, there is one option that we always have to pay attention to, because I've realized that in certain cases, people may actually not be able to interpret their data using regions because they may have not enabled certain features. So in case your map options are not displaying the kind of data that you're trying to interpret, you may simply have to go to your file button. And from here, you can access the options and settings, and you can go to options. And in this area, we're able to manipulate what kind of data must actually be interpreted. For example, if we come to security over here, we have different options in here. If we scroll all the way down, you'd notice that we have custom visuals and we have ArcGIS over here for Power BI, which is not selected. So if maybe you're working with some municipal council, or you're working with a department that requires to map data in different geographical locations, etc., and you want to feed data that is coming from ArcGIS to be interpreted in ArcGIS for Power BI, you must enable this feature. And it's the same thing for map and field map visuals. This feature over here must be enabled in order for us to use different types of maps within Power BI. That's very important for us to remember. So I do not really have my own data, and I've added a link below this particular video where we can actually access a particular sample or a template from Microsoft containing different types of data sets that we can use for this particular example. And it is that Excel sheet that I'm going to use for this demonstration. So I'm just going to go ahead and select Excel workbook over here. And from here, I'll select the financial sample, which is the file that I got from Microsoft. And then I'll go ahead and open that. And you'd realize that once it opens within this particular area, it informs us of the kind of data that we have. Over here, we can see that these are the financials we've got over here. And we have sheet one. So if we had sheet two, sheet three, we could go ahead and also select those as we progressed. But then let's go ahead and just select what we have over there and click on load. So it'll go ahead and load that data for us. And once the loading is done, we actually can go ahead and view the data. Now, what did we say is the rightful view mode for us to view raw data? It's supposed to be table mode. So if we go to table view over here, we can see different types of data there. We can see different countries. You can see discount brand, units sold, etc. But if we really want to view the data, we still have to go back to the report view. And over here, this is where we can begin having various visuals brought in. They could be pie charts, they could be stack bars, they could be different types of tables and maps, etc. And if we wanted to have visibility into the relationships, we have to go and make use of the model view, because it's from here that we'll be able to look into the various relationships of the data that we have. Now, back in the report view, we can begin the process of filtering the various types of data sets, or filtering the types of information we'd like to see appear in these visuals. And again, this is where visualization happens. We do not view data from the table view. The table view, yes, it is great. We can actually look at the data raw as it is over here, but no business development manager, no investor, no business person would like to look at raw data. It is just difficult to interpret. So once it's brought into the report view, everybody, including me, can now be able to tell whether we're making a loss or we're making profit as a company. So over here, if we just look at the far right-hand side, we've got financials over here, and this is our data. So we can begin looking at what information is great for us to have. What is it that we want to look at? Is it dates? Are we interested in sales? Are we interested in profits? Are we interested in maybe the name of the month? So we can begin ticking or simply dragging these into this area over here. And as we drag them, we can begin adjusting them as desired. And for instance, if this is something that we want to look into, oh, we're looking at sales, for example, but I would like to know what maybe the gross sale was like, and then we can add that over there. Or maybe we'd like to look at the months in which these sales were happening, and then we can begin filling that information. Over here, we can see we've got October to March. And we can go on and on looking at various units that are contained within our data. For example, we'll be able to tell that this was our gross sale. And from that, it gives us information as to what exactly was the total amount of sales before any deductions were done on whatever merchandise or products that we're selling. And we can also correlate this data based on the different regions or locations where the sales were happening. For example, over here, we've got country. So if we select country over there, or if we simply drag it, in fact, this is a different method in which you can actually select to have a table-like view of the different locations. But if we wanted to have it in a map sort of like display or visualization, then you can simply drag it to a different location within this canvas area. And oh, there we go. You'd realize that over here it says map and field map visuals aren't enabled. So we have to go ahead and enable that prior to us having access to that data. So follow the same process of going to the file tab and from here accessing options and settings. From options, manipulate the security settings of this particular area. So go to security and there we have use map and field map enabled already. I wouldn't really know why it wouldn't allow us to make use of that. So just go ahead and enable it again to just ensure that we have everything set before we can go ahead and try to put in data that requires us to make use of maps. Okay, so after disabling and enabling it, I'll just go ahead and remove this particular part from my canvas and I'll drag the country section again in this area for the second time. And that did not work. All right, so there is a way in which we could actually work around various features within the admin center to try and bring in the maps. However, I had no intentions of getting into Microsoft Power BI service as of yet, but because we need that feature, I'm going to open my browser. And from my browser, there we have Power BI. And this is what we actually refer to as Power BI service. We'll start the discussion on Power BI in a moment. However, if you haven't been able to access your Power BI feature and you are maybe in your Microsoft 365 Admin Center, all you've got to do is to go to menu and from here you've got Power BI over there. So this is the same section. So in here you have to go to the settings cog and from here access admin portal. And from the admin portal, notice that you have tenant settings. Now these are the two areas we can make configurations that pertain to our maps or ArcGIS or anything that has to do with visuals within Power BI. So it's this one and the security privacy option we saw earlier. So somewhere over here, we've got integration settings. And here you can see you've got ArcGIS, you've got Azure Maps, and you've got map and field map visuals. It's here that we have to go and enable that feature over there. Now it takes some time to actually update once selected, but once we have enabled that and we click on apply, we should actually be good to go. There it says approximately 15 minutes for it to be able to update, but I'll just go ahead and minimize this and come back into this area. Sometimes it could be quicker. So I'll get my country option and drag it into the canvas and there we go. So this is one of the features we needed to enable in order for us to have access to that. And we can begin gaining visibility into the various areas where these sales are taking place. For example, looking at the sum of sales over here and we can see all those locations over there. And we can continue to add more and more information to help our teams understand the trajectory of our business. For instance, over here, we can tell the months that had the highest sum of sales and we can have greater visibility into that. And if there is a need for us to add additional information, we can still go ahead and do that. Perhaps we want to look into the units sold per maybe product or per month. We can also look at that. So in this case, if we went and picked up units sold, for example, we can bring it in here and maybe we could also select the name of the product. So we'll go ahead and select product over there. We can always change these visuals to different types of visuals that we have within this build visual area. For instance, if we select this option and select the pie chart over here, that would easily change into a pie chart. And we can use that to interpret the information that we are seeing over here from the various products we've got on our legend over here, the different color codes indicating sales for each and every product we have in our environment. And this becomes easy to interpret. It's easy to see and anybody can actually see where there's growth and where sales are diminishing. And this becomes very easy if we wanted to publish this or maybe share it with the rest of our team. It's easy for us to do that. And that is why we are now going to look at the Microsoft Power BI service and create a contrast of the two platforms. Thanks for watching and remember to hit that subscribe button to get the latest from CBT Nuggets. And if you are new to IT or just keen to sharpen your IT skills, then be sure to check out cbtnuggets.com and sign up for a free trial.